This is a bunch of nice and shiny mercury metal, and I'm going to use it to do something that I think is kind of magical. To get started, the first thing I'll need is some concentrated nitric acid. Then into this, I'll add a small amount of the mercury metal. Almost immediately, it started reacting, and the whole thing turned yellow. Then over the next several minutes, it got darker and darker, and it started letting off some scary fumes. As the reaction continued, the fumes slowly got even scarier, and all of the acid started boiling. What was happening here was a reaction between the mercury metal and the nitric acid. All of the mercury was being turned into mercury nitrate, which would dissolve into the acid. All of the red gas was just a byproduct, and it was really important to not breathe it in. After about 20 minutes, all of the mercury was gone. The reaction still wasn't quite done, though. So what I had to do next was turn on my hot plate and bring it to a boil. It ended up taking a lot longer than expected, but after almost an hour, it was completely colorless. What I had now was a concentrated solution of mercury nitrate, and I diluted it with a bunch of cold water. Now I can add the final ingredient, which is a solution of potassium iodide. This almost instantly reacted, and it was turning the mercury nitrate into mercury iodide, which wasn't soluble in water. When I was done adding it, I stirred it around, and then I let it sit there for a while. The really dense mercury iodide quickly sank to the bottom, and the next thing I had to do was filter it off. So I poured it all into a coffee filter, and I washed everything a few times with some extra water. I let it sit here for about a day to dry, and then I spread it out on some paper towel. A few days later, it looked nice and crispy, and I was able to crush it into a powder. Now, I finally had some dry mercury iodide, and it's time for the magical part. To make this happen, all I have to do is pour all of it into a dish and spread it around. I'll then put it on a hot plate and I'll crank up the heating. As it warmed up, it slowly turned dark red, and when it eventually got hot enough, some of it started turning yellow. This yellow part then kept growing, and the red color slowly disappeared. It ended up taking a lot longer than I thought, but I was eventually left with a completely yellow powder. What I think is cool, though, is what happens when I turn off the hot plate. Some of the red color starts coming back, and this is happening because the powder's cooling down. This color-changing effect, based on temperature, is called thermochromism, and I really think it almost looks like magic.